On February 19, many residents gathered at Shenzhen Bay Port to welcome the volunteers of the Shenzhen Rescue Volunteers Federation, who just returned from Turkey. The city treated them with the utmost hospitality. On February 6, a 7.8 magnitude earthquake struck southeastern Turkey. The Shenzhen Rescue Volunteers Federation quickly responded and organized a team to participate in the rescue operations in Turkey. Chen Yuan was the leader of the Shenzhen Rescue Team.
所以我们要代购180公斤的物资，基本上没有太多问题，就是大家需要在飞机上还要再把工作细化一下，然后熟悉我们所有的地图，还有名称，还有需要去对接的把它明确下来。
其他有什么问题没有？大家
没有，
因为我是城市搜救队的队长，在这样的重大灾害面前，我是一定是义不容辞的，要去能够投入到当中去的。我就是作为一名这个队员出去的。
After returning to Shenzhen, Shenzhen Daily interviewed Chen at the Federation's office. During the interview, we observed her courage, kindness, and compassion, as well as her ability to remain objective, rational, and composed as the rescue team's leader.
当地首的这个灾情，而且和当地的灾害应急管理部门建立联系，和联合国和其他队伍建立联系，这是我们要做的第一步。这个工作包括寻找我们的这个营地的地址，还有当地的对接，包括车辆的安排呀，还有当地向导的安排呀，这些都是我们和后方一起协作的。
The emergency rescue profession has seen many women as capable as Chen in its ranks. They possess robust physical abilities, comprehensive rescue knowledge, proficient rescue skills, and strong psychological resilience.
那接下来几天呢，比较辛苦的一直持续工作，然后短暂的休息，只要有这种求助的信息，我马上去核实，马上就开展搜救。Again.
�esimi duyuyor musun? Sesimi duyuyorsan bir yerlere vur.
其实女性在这个我们这个队伍里面承担了非常多的工作，除了在一线，比如救援救灾以外，比如说信息的工作、后勤的工作、文书整理的工作，或者说是一些行政方面的工作，也有大量的队员在做。比如说女性是比较细腻，包括在医疗处置方面，她对伤员的关怀，能够语言的安慰，或者甚至只是我就拉着你的手，女性就能做到。
Like many of Chen's team members, she has faced significant devastation and difficulties during her first trip to Turkey.
那边气温比较低，居住帐篷，睡地垫，不能洗澡，面临着有余震，然后这个工作时间比较长，很劳累。
As a non-governmental rescue team from Shenzhen, Chen Yuan and her team members exhibited remarkable competency and coordination skills throughout the international rescue operation.
But fourth is missing. My parents' room was there.
Their thinking has two people.
And the local guy, he said around 100 to 150 with the dead and alive body.
大家的合作目标是一致的。 虽然可能语言有的说英语，有的说德语，有的说土耳其语，然后不同的队伍会有不同的做事的方法，但是非常好的就是大家那个时候目标很一致。
They perform various tasks such as technical and manual searches, demolishing and removing rubble, and operating heavy machinery. Their efforts resulted in the successful rescue of 3 trapped individuals and the recovery of 10 casualties from beneath the rubble.
其实任务结束了，但是我们感觉到还有很多的这种，怎么说，就觉得非常遗憾，因为每一次我们只要探测到有一定微弱的生命体征的时候，这个所有人的希望都是真的是在现场，就是祈祷啊，希望能够把他们能够带出来，就是幸存者。那我们只要有一丝希望，都会竭尽全力。
Thank you.